LA is great. The weather is great. The amount of people that you meet from different parts of the world is just an awesome place to live.
Everyone lives in Southern California knowing that it's earthquake country, but they come anyways because it's such a great place to live and work.
We actually happen to live in one of the biggest seismic areas in California.
You're pretty much 10 miles or less from the nearest earthquake fault. You get safety ratings for cars, you know the calorie information on your food, but you walk into buildings and nobody thinks, well, when was this building built? And is this building safe? And is it vulnerable to an earthquake?
Here in Southern California, because we have so much land, fairly large buildings were constructed that have a lot of open parking underneath it. Well, because of that reason, a lot of these buildings actually don't have a lot of wall around in the first story. And that creates a very weak piece of the puzzle in the building. If an earthquake hits it, it's gonna break at that location. Eventually that bottom gives out and collapses on top of the first story.
Soft story buildings are predominantly apartment buildings. They're not buildings that you can just demolish because they make up such a large percentage of the affordable housing in Los Angeles.
In 1994, we saw over 200 buildings of this type actually be damaged. One particular building killed 16 people. The city of Los Angeles has estimated that they have over 13,000 of these types of structures just in their city. So it's important for our communities to not only understand that there's a problem, but hopefully also go and retrofit their buildings. So in November of 2015, the city of Los Angeles came up with an ordinance that covers both non-ductile concrete buildings and wood soft story buildings. It covers buildings that have four or more units, and it must have been designed prior to 1978.
There are several options that a building owner can take if they need to retrofit their soft story building. One is they can put more walls up. The problem with that, no one wants to lose their precious garage space by putting up walls, so that's not a very viable option. The solution that I've seen the most is using a steel moment frame, so using steel columns and steel beams to reinforce those openings at the bottom of the building, and using a connection type that's going to be able to resist the loads that you'll see in that next earthquake.
Once you start talking about moment frames, you actually have some options. The engineer can design a custom steel moment frame, but there are also vendors out there that have proprietary systems. When you create your own moment frame on site, it could be more expensive, and there's also a lot of inspection quality control on site.
What Simpson has done with our strong frame special moment frame is eliminating field welding. We're eliminating having to do special inspection of the connection. We have an unparalleled dedication and investment to making sure that all of our products are tested, that they're safe.
The proprietary system has the benefit that a lot of those parts are done in a very controlled environment. When you bring it to the site, you're already getting a frame that has been thoroughly inspected, and you can now worry about the installation.
Every building is different, so you do need a moment frame that is built and designed specifically for that project, and so that's what we do at Simpson Strong-Tie. We have a very high quality control process to design and manufacture the frames here in Southern California. The frames get shipped to the job site. There's no waiting for any other components to complete it. A traditional moment frame connection relies on your beam being the member that absorbs all your energy in an earthquake. In the strong frame special moment frame, it's the yield link that is designed to be the element that absorbs the energy and stretches and twists. So as a result, instead of having to replace the entire frame with the traditional steel moment frame, you just have to replace these four elements, which is a huge cost savings for the building owner and a huge time savings for the tenants who want to continue living in the building.
We take great responsibility in what we do. It's about the people that live here. If they don't have anywhere to live, then we lost the community.
Ultimately, what we're trying to do is save lives. We want to build safer buildings, create safer communities that are going to enable people to survive the next event, but really thrive after it as well.